Beth with 50 Plus Beauty, and I'm really glad you're here with me today to talk about human growth hormone, also known as HGH, and ways we can increase human growth hormone naturally. Now, the theme of this channel is making our second half our best half, and part of that is looking our best through great makeup and wonderful skincare, but it's also about actually becoming healthier and more physically fit so that our second half can be truly wonderful. Now, none of us wants to spend our 70s or 80s with diabetes, heart disease, or cancer, and during our 50s, we need to start doing those things which assure our good health now and in the future throughout our second half. Now, if you'd like to make your second half your best half in body, mind, and spirit, I hope you'll click that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and or share it with a friend, because all of those things help this video do better, which I would really appreciate. Okay, now, I need to start out by saying that I kind of stumbled on the idea of increasing my human growth hormone as the result of my weightlifting. Now, those of you who have been watching my channel for a while know that in around this past January, about 6 months ago, I've been lifting weights and I have really been loving it. And I'll link my weightlifting progress video below for those of you who haven't seen it because the results are amazing. Well, as part of my weightlifting, I'd started to take creatine as it helps to increase lean muscle mass. And as I was researching creatine, I came upon a great video by Dr. Ken Berry, and there he is. His video is about the benefits of HGH and how to get more of it naturally. And once I saw that video, I was surprised because I realized that I was already doing several of those things even before I saw that video. So I decided to add a few more of the items Dr. Berry suggested and really take my human growth hormone production to a new level and see how it went for me and then share it with you on this channel. And I will tell you that I'm linking Dr. Berry's video below, and if you go visit his channel, please mention that I said hi and that I referred you to his video. Okay, for about the past month, I've been doing all the things that Dr. Berry mentioned in the video to increase my human growth hormone, and I'll tell you about those results in just a few moments, but first I'd like to give you some general information about human growth hormone and its anti-aging benefits, because it is a wonder worker in terms of anti-aging. Now, we've all heard about HGH, and we've heard that the movie stars and athletes sometimes take it to look younger, and that is on the black market because it is not legal unless it's prescribed by your doctor, and in many cases, that kind of use is just not. But there are ways to increase our HGH naturally, and you may wonder what HGH is exactly. I know I did myself. And basically, it's a growth hormone that is secreted in the pituitary gland at the base of our brains. And we produce the most HGH in our bodies when we were very young and growing, perhaps in our teenage years. But by the time we were 30, we hit the height of our HGH hormone production. And from there, it was all downhill, like a lot of things to do with aging. And now at my age of 60, my level of HGH production is probably very, very slight. And the reduction in human growth hormone leaves us feeling tired and worn out and not really looking our best either. Now, symptoms of low HGH are thinner skin and hair, which is not fun, decreased mood and concentration, and more fat around our midsections. HGH has also been shown to increase our metabolism, which is wonderful, improve our skin, strengthen our muscles and bones, lift our mood, and even help our brains and memories become sharper. And as I mentioned, about a month ago, I started a program to increase my level of HGH naturally. And I want to stress that this is just what I'm doing, and please consult with your medical professional before taking any kind of medical action, because I am definitely not a doctor. Now, following are some of the best ways to increase your HGH naturally. The first way is to improve your sleep. And that's because the vast majority of HGH is produced while we sleep. Now, I used to just say, oh, I don't sleep very much, I don't need a lot of sleep, and that is not good for my health at all. And that if I want to continue to look and feel my best, I need to get more sleep because that will enhance my HGH production. And so, in other words, I need to make getting a good night's sleep a priority, and I hope you will too. That means we can do things like setting a regular bedtime that will enable us to get 7 to 8 hours of sleep, switching off the TV and computers or cell phones maybe 30 minutes before we want to doze off, and keeping the room we sleep in as dark as possible, and they say 68 degrees is the perfect temperature for your bedroom. Also, midnight is said to be the height of HGH production, so it's very important that we get to bed around 10 or 10:30 so that by the time midnight rolls around, we are in a deep sleep and ready to increase our stores of HGH. Now, the second way to increase your HGH is to skip breakfast. That's right, try intermittent fasting. Now, intermittent fasting sounds kind of complicated, but it's really super simple. Our bodies produce more HGH when we're slightly hungry in kind of a fasting state, and it's simple to do intermittent fasting. What I do is I just skip breakfast, and instead I have my first meal of the day around 10:30 or 11 o'clock in the morning when I eat lunch. And then I try not to snack between lunch and dinner, and I usually finish dinner around 7 o'clock p.m. That means I'm fasting for that window 15, 16 hours a day from the last meal of the day to 10:30 or 11 o'clock in the morning when I eat my first meal of the day. And then I have about an 8-hour time period where I'm eating from lunch to dinner. Now, intermittent fasting has been shown to increase HGH production by as much as 2,000% in men and 3,000% in women. And I've linked Dr. Ken Berry's video below in which he discusses the research on that and many other details linked to increasing your HGH. Now, another way to increase your HGH naturally is to get high-intensity interval training. And it doesn't take long to do that, and it's really a simple way to exercise, and it's much more effective than going all out and doing 50-minute workouts a day. For instance, I work out fairly regularly on the elliptical. And what I do is that I work out for a total of 15 minutes on the elliptical 3 times a week. And here's how I do each 15-minute workout. Now, during the workout, I go at my normal pace for about 2 minutes, followed by 1 minute of going fast and furious and as hard as I can. Then I do another 2 minutes at a more regular pace, followed by another minute where I'm going fast and going so fast, actually, that I almost can't catch my breath. You've got to get out of breath during that minute of that high intensity interval training. Now, during that 1 minute of your high intensity interval training, you should go so hard and fast that it leaves you totally breathless and maybe sweating a little bit. Studies show that you shouldn't overdo high interval training and that you need less than 50 minutes of this type of training per week. For instance, my 3 15-minute workouts on the elliptical, all three of those 15 minutes of workout come to 45 minutes a week, so that's about right. Now, I'll put a link to a video by Dr. Brad Stanfield in which he discusses the research behind this and how high-intensity interval training truly does increase your HGH. Next, there are supplements you can take to increase your HGH. In Dr. Berry's video, he went through the research behind these supplements you can take. The first supplement he recommended is melatonin, and I was already taking that supplement to help me sleep. And that's because studies have shown that taking 1 to 5 milligrams of melatonin at bedtime can actually double the amount of HGH that you produce while you sleep. I can't believe it. It can double the amount of your HGH. Melatonin is also good for helping you get to sleep, and it's great at helping you stay asleep. And so actually you have double the benefits from melatonin. It helps you sleep and it does increase your HGH. Now, another supplement that's been shown to increase your HGH is creatine. And that's the weightlifting supplement I had already started taking. And if you're eating a diet that's rich in fatty meats like beef or pork or something like that, you're probably already getting enough creatine. Creatine has been studied extensively in hundreds of studies over many years, and it's proven to help you build muscle and improve your athletic performance. And I must say, maybe it's because I'm a female, but I never really thought of myself as an athlete before. But I think that is a good mental shift for us to make, because once you start thinking of yourself as an athlete, you start to take working out seriously. And I have been doing that, and it's resulted in a very healthy shift in perspective for me to think of myself as an athlete, because not only am I thinking of the number of workouts I do each week, but I'm taking each of those workouts more seriously. Now, another supplement shown to increase your HGH naturally is called GABA. It stands for gamma-aminobutyric acid. That's a mouthful. Gamma is a substance our bodies make naturally, but of course, as we get older, our bodies tend to make less and less of it. Now, GABA is supposed to help with sleep, and many people take it before bedtime, although I tried it the first night doing that, and it kept me up all night long. It was a horrible stimulant for me. So now I take it in the morning along with my other supplements, and I find that it gives me energy throughout the day, and actually I feel like I am sleeping a little better at night, so maybe it is having the sleeping benefit for me too. Now, as I mentioned, I've been following all of the above for the past month, and this is not a super long time to give you any great report about it, but initially I had a couple of interesting observations. The first is that I feel like I'm feeling more energy. Before, around 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I would just get a little bit draggy and feel like I wanted to take a nap. Well, in the past month, my energy level has been high and consistent throughout each day, and I've really rarely had the idea that I needed to take a nap. And the second thing that was very interesting is that I lost weight. And actually, I didn't even want to lose weight. I'm 5'6", and normally I like to weigh around 122 pounds. And when COVID started, I have to admit, I crept up near 130, which kind of scared me. But when I started all this, I was right at 122. And then within a couple of weeks, I was down at 115 pounds, which for me is kind of scarecrow zone. I mean, I was starting to look really weird, kind of sucked in, and it was not a good look for me. So to combat that weight loss, I did start eating more carbs and eating a little more frequently. And I'm really not sure what it is that caused me to lose that weight, but I'm kind of thinking it had to do with that intermittent fasting and waiting to eat my first meal until around 10:30 or 11, because I've noticed that whenever I do the intermittent fasting, the weight just cannot stay on. It just drops off. And if you're looking just for weight loss, if I were you, I might keep the same calories you're eating now, but just start eating your breakfast around 10:30 or 11, and I think you'll find that you'll lose weight as well. Well, that was a look at my first experiment using some tools and techniques to increase my human growth hormone naturally. And in future videos, I hope you'll subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see the rest of that journey. And again, if you could give this video a thumbs up and/or share it with a friend, that would be just great. Well, normally at this point in the video, I read one of these Miracles Now cards from Gabrielle Bernstein, and we talk about a positive thought. But instead of doing that today, I just wanted to share with you briefly a little bit about what I'm doing on my channel now and in the future, because I am thinking that if the mission of this channel is for all of us to live our best half in our second half, then good health has to be a part of that. So in addition to the hair, makeup, and skincare, which I will never leave behind, I love that, I am also going to be doing more of these health-related videos to help us look and feel our best. And I will say that in terms of skincare, I've got some fabulous new things coming up. Some arm skincare. A lot of you are asking how to get rid of the crepiness on your body skin, and we're going to be working on that. We're going to be doing some chemical peels on different parts of our body to improve our skin. Wonderful new things are coming up on my channel, and I can't wait to share them with you. Take care, and I'll see you in my next video.